Are you guys ready? 21 Project Pan items for 2021. Hey everybody, it's Jasmine, and today I'm really excited because here I have a layout of all of the products that I want to at least pan or finish up. Mostly it's a finish up project for me as opposed to just hitting pan. So I have 21 products that I have here that I feel like will be very successful for this upcoming year. I'm gonna start from primers and I'm going to end with the lip products in a way where I actually do my makeup and my makeup routine. So let's go ahead with the primers. This is my oldest primer in my collection. This is the Kaja Blur Drop. It's a weightless water primer. It's a silicone-based primer. Now, I want to use this because it is pretty old, and I feel like I don't necessarily use a lot of silicone primers in general, and I feel like I can go through this pretty fast if I do try. The next one that I have here is the Juno & Co. Moonshine Miracle Cream. I am halfway done with this, but a little bit does go a very long way, so I know that during this entire year, I do think that two primers is pretty feasible for me. During 2020, I believe I ran through about 6 bottles of foundation, which is a lot. That's a lot. But I just thought, you know what, I'm going to challenge myself with bottles that are pretty much full. So I have 2 foundations here, which is the Tarte Face Tape, which is what I'm wearing today. And then I also have the Nars All Day Luminous Weightless Foundation. And I love both of these. Both of these are the perfect shade match for me. The Tarte is in light medium sand and Nars is in Punjab. So I really do love these and I'm excited because these are actual formulas that I'm not really going to get tired of. I might regret this, but I'm gonna tell myself I am not going to. So I have 3 different powders. I am not an oily person by any means. I am a normal skin type, but I do love to have a matte foundation base with a dewy, hydrated skincare routine underneath, if that makes any sense. So here I have my Shiseido loose powder, and this one's in the shade Radiant. The only reason why I want to add this to the project is because I actually don't use this, and I feel like it's a great powder. I did pay almost full price for it. I do think I got it for like 15% off, but that's literally like just tax off. So I want to just get more use out of this. I feel like it's a great powder, but I just think the Radiant claim just always throws me off every single time, and that's the reason why I don't use it. The next one that I have here is my Holy Grail ShopMissA Perfect Press Powder in the shade Banana. I love this stuff so much, and I know I could get through it in a year, but I just really want to see if I can within like a couple of months. I don't know. I just want to challenge myself. And finally, I have another Holy Grail item, which is my Shiseido Powder Foundation in the shade 220 Linen. I have major dents in this, but I want to see if I could actually finish it up in a year. The next category are my bronzers, blushes, and highlights. Now, I have already gone through a full product of this in the past, but this is my e.l.f. Bronze Beauty Bronzer Palette. There are 2 mattes and 2 shimmers in here. So when you mix them all together, you get like this beautiful sun-kissed glow. It's really nice. I have major dents in all 4 shades, so I feel like I can reach pan, but the real test for me is if I could finish all 4 shades within this year. I'm crazy because I feel like I have to use up the entire thing in order to feel really satisfied. So I'm gonna see how far I could go with this one. I'm pretty sure I can do it. It's just gonna take a lot of effort. For blush, I have my favorite discontinued MAC blush. This is in the shade Trace Gold. I'm not gonna open it because it's actually crumbly and I need to repress it, but it is like this beautiful, like rosy gold shade. It has like the perfect amount of shine to it, to the face. It's definitely really natural. It's nothing too pink or peachy. It's literally like a gold sheen over the skin. And just like my 2020 project pan, I don't expect myself to fully use these. I actually just want to see me hit pan on them. So I have 2 different highlighters. I have one here that's really old. This is the Laura Geller Gilded Honey. I just feel like I need to use it up. This has been in my collection for so incredibly long and I use it a lot. I have used it, I think, in mostly 2018 for me, and I used it almost every single day. So I'm hoping that I can see pan. I'm not gonna kick myself in the butt if I don't, because it is a baked product and those type of products really do take so long to go through. And then the next one that I have here is Real Her Keep Going. This is just a beautiful highlighter that I love to wear whenever I want a beaming highlighter. Now, I do have major dents in this one too, but a little bit goes such a long way with both of these products, so I feel like it's possible, but again, I'm not gonna beat myself up in the butt if I don't see that pan by the end of the year. We have a couple of singular items for the eyes. Now I have here the Kaja Moon Crystal. Now the only reason why I'm adding this in is because it expires in 2021. It expires in July. So I am hoping to just get as much use as I can out of this. I actually just got this like maybe 2 or 3 weeks ago and it already expires in July, which blows my mind. But I just want to get through it before it expires. And then I have here the Touch and Soul Metallist Foil Pigment in the shade number 2. It's what I'm using on my eyelids today, and this one does expire in 2023, but I want to see how far I could use it because it is a single shadow and I feel like it might dry up. I don't know, I just have an inkling of it, so I just want to get more use out of it. I was on FaceTime with Kate last night and we were trying to figure out what eyeshadow palettes I wanted to use to pan. Now, I want to say for this year, my goal is to pan one eyeshadow from each palette. I think that's feasible. I think that I think I could do that. So here I have the ColourPop Sweet Talk palette. I really love this palette because of the formula variety. You get the Super Shock formula, you get the regular shimmers, you get the mattes, and you get the glitter. So I really do love that, and I feel like I could probably go through the Super Shock formula pretty fast because that is the one color in this palette that I really dug into. So hopefully we could go through this a little bit more than I already have. Here is my Dose of Colors Friendcation palette. The blue eyeshadow fell out. That's not okay. That's really not okay. That's not fine. But yeah, I use this all the time on my clients. I have a separate one for my client kit as well as for myself. And I definitely hit pan on my client kit one, so I feel like I could do that for myself. The next palette that we have here is another ColourPop palette. This is the So Jaded, and I genuinely feel like this is possible because this is one of my favorite nude and colored palettes just in general that I own. I love the variety of tones in here. I feel like they are muted, but I feel like they're muted enough to the point where it can be like a wearable, like colorful look, you know what I mean? So I do like this, and I don't know what shade I would really go through, but I mean, I use this a lot. Probably Geodude. I think that would be a realistic shade for me, but we'll see. I just want to pan one shadow in each of these palettes. We are almost done with this video. Now I have two brow products. I'm gonna roll over this product from last year, my Wet n Wild Brow Powder Duo in the shade Ash Brown. I use this in my brows today. I use it every single day, and I feel like I could actually finish it by next year. I did do a pretty good job for 2020, but I felt like a lot of the days I actually didn't wear my makeup. And then alongside that, I decided to toss in a brow gel. This is the Benefit Gimme Brow in the shade number 4. Number 4 is pretty light, but I feel like if I have a super dark brow that day, I could always tame it down with this one. So I want to see how far I could use both of these products because I feel like I have a really hard time in general remembering to do eyebrow gel. I wanted to test myself again this year to use up an eyeliner, so I decided to go in with a Kohl liner because I feel like liquid liners, I rotate through them pretty quickly because some of them dry out, some of them expire more, and I feel like when you have a pencil, it lasts a little bit longer because you can sharpen it. So this one is the Real Her I Am Resilient. This one did launch in 2020, and this was probably like my favorite Real Her launch that they had because it is so beautiful. It's like this beautiful golden bronze. It just looks so good. It stays in the waterline even if you cry, and that is a true test right there. That is honestly like the test of time. So I'm really excited to use this more during 2021. I did use a lot of it during 2020 already, but I just want to see how far I could get. Finally, for lip products, I decided to go in with my Shiseido lip liner in the shade Espresso. And the only reason why I chose this one is because it is retractable, but I feel like this amount of product that this has, you know, I feel like I could do it. I really do. I feel like it's not a lot, but knowing that it's lip liner and that you only use it on a small area on your face, I feel like it will last me during the whole year. Plus, this is a super dark color, so we'll see about that. And then as far as the lipstick is concerned, it is the lipstick that I'm wearing on my lips right now. I have an inkling that we still are going to be wearing masks throughout 2021, so I wanted to include a liquid lipstick this time. So I have here my favorite liquid lipstick from ColourPop. This is by I Love Sarai, and it is the Sueño de Coco shade. So there you have it, everyone, the 21 products that I want to finish in 2021. I do have goals to finish the majority of these, but you know, there are some things that I know that I'm not gonna finish through and through, which is fine. I have smaller goals for those, but for the most part, I wanna really like knock them out, like really just like get out of here. So I hope that I could do that this time around. I'm really happy with my progress for 2020's Project Pan, so I do have high hopes for this one. I did learn a lot about myself during the Project Pan, and I feel like I am just very determined to really see that pan. Like, I'm really crazy about it. I really am. It's an addiction. So I hope you guys all enjoy this one. Let me know if you guys are going to be doing a 2021 Project Pan this year or not, or if you just want to see me, you know, go through these throughout the whole year. Of course, I do want to not only use these products, but the other products in my collection as well. I just have a lot of products that I feel like only have a couple of uses out of them, and these ones for the most part are pretty full. So I wanted to include that more for this panning project here. So thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you guys in my next one. Bye. Peace out, Girl Scouts.